And Jesus shows us a perfect example of evangelism in this text. He does not preach at her. He does not say, I am the Savior of the world by which you will be redeemed. He didn't say, I'm coming to conquer hell, death, and the grave. He didn't say anything like that. He was so deep, so spiritual, pastor, so profound. He said, can you give me a drink of water? Samaritans and Jews didn't get along, so she looks at Jesus and says, what do you mean? You're a Jew. How can you ask a Samaritan for something to drink? Now, I can see Jesus, you know, for those of you who ain't with the imagery, just looking at her like she was a fool. Well, if you knew who you was talking to, you would ask, you know, of him, and he would give you living water. Well, she's still a natural, so I want some of this living water. You know, what's up with it? He says, this water that you drink from here, you'll thirst again, but the water I give you, you'll drink from and you'll never thirst again. Amen. Well, if you pay attention, as I said, Jesus started off by just having a conversation. A lot of people think evangelism is preaching at folks. Sometimes you're just talking to people. You know, you're on your job, somebody's going through something, and you're just a listening ear. It doesn't take you to quote them scriptures, because a lot of the people that's not in the church don't know the scriptures, so why are you throwing it at them?
Yes.
Jesus had this divine appointment, and again, he begins the conversation real simple, just, can I get a drink of water? And he uses the well as a reference, as a sense of relatability. In other words, he finds a common ground with the woman. He doesn't preach at it, he just finds a common ground with the woman, he starts talking to her. And in the midst of his conversation, instead of coming at her, he offers her something more than she can obtain herself. Y'all don't mind, do y'all? Okay. He offers her something more than she can obtain herself. Oftentimes we'll preach to people and at them and tell them what they need and what they must do, but we don't offer them any more than what they can already get. People with financial issues don't need you to tell them a way to get more money. They really don't. People that have good positions don't need you to tell them how to go higher up in anarchy. What they need from you is more than that. He offers her living water from which she'll find peace, joy, love, happiness. The stuff of her past won't hold her down. But we offer people stuff that they can easily get themselves. When's the last time you went to somebody and said, I know you're going through this, but I know Jesus and he offers peace? When's the last time you went to somebody and said, I know you're going through this and you need money, but I know a God who provides? They don't need another strategy. They need Christ. They need God. What are you being strategic for? They need God. They don't need more methods. Now, Jesus, you know, oddly enough, you see that the disciples aren't with him because he likes to, you know, cut out and get by himself. And the beautiful thing about it is I didn't pay much mind to it until I realized that what they were talking about by the well was too deep for some people. As Pastor David's already said, sometimes it's hard to be honest in the church because the church has invisible rules. You can only go but so far with your testimony. You can only say but so much. And if you touch on sex, if you touch on homosexuality, if you touch on lesbianism, you're going just a tad bit too far over the line. But see, Jesus got away from the disciples and had a personal, intimate moment with this woman. Got all up in her business. He said, listen, go get your husband. I don't have a husband. Well, see, you're not lying there. See, the last five you had weren't yours, and the one you got now isn't yours. Now, out of the shock of what was just said to her, she said, you must be a prophet. She lost her mind, dropped her pail, and ran into town. Now this is where the honesty kicks in. She comes in and gives a testimony to the people. Come meet a man that told me everything I ever did. And off of the pureness of the testimony, off the honesty, the people followed. And they sat amongst Jesus and offer her testimony. They learned for themselves who Jesus really was. This shows me that evangelism is really an intimate moment. You can preach to people, that's great. But to really get somebody, you got to get intimate with them. And God will send divine people that have been where you've been or are going where you've been into your life. And you have to speak to that situation. So that means sometimes you have to be uncomfortable. You have to be really honest with yourself. The stuff that you don't want to address, you're going to have to address. See, in the midst of evangelizing to someone, you don't just minister to them, you minister to yourself. Because now you have to address some things that you left in your past.